gosh, he's a lovely lad, isn't he? Has he a lovely lad?
Does he take after you?
Well, I'm a modest man, but I bet he does. Now, what if Rossi Lamb observed so much of his granny in it at all?
I'm not his gran. Yeah, I'm his auntie. I don't care how glamorous grannies are. Aunties are younger and more attractive.
Don't let anyone of my generation hear you saying that, love. Seeing the estate agent. I might as well find out how much my house is worth.
She's moved down south to be with her son.
Oh, really? Are you enjoying it?
Yeah, very nice.
Fred Elliot, I want a word with you.
Lillian? Somebody can see you.
You're a coward, you are. Yellow-bellied and spineless.
Lillian makes the business decisions. My place is in back row.
What's going on?
I am on my lunch break.
Oh, sheep!
You've sacked a good worker, you have. You've chucked my husband on the scrap heap.
I've put a malingerer back where he belongs.
My husband's not frightened of hard work.
Your husband wouldn't know a day's work from a packet of peanuts.
Hey, you! Watch your mouth!
This is a pub, not a rest home. He needs constant care. Well, you can't get it here.
Look, employers have a duty to look after their employees.
Is he hurt himself picking up a beer mat? He could sue us for thousands.
Give over. We used to run this place.
Yes, I've heard, and apparently you made a right shambles of it.
Who do you think you're talking to?
Ghosts. You're from a vanished era. This pub's going up market. Plastic earrings and nylon shirts can take themselves off to the flying horse.
Yes, and they will and all.
Well, good.
Look, are you going to let her talk to us like this?
She's the landlady.
Yes. Well, she'll empty the place. Rover's return over the emptiest pub in Weatherfield.
Never.
Oh, come on, Jack.